Yeah. So, I don't know. This is one of those different situations in life where, you know, things don't go as planned. Yeah, as you can hear. So, this is actually WoW Gold versus Clash for Gold. Let's see, WoW Gold episode 32, I hope, and Clash for Gold episode 6. And it's titled Blizzard versus Supercell, Dawn of Justice. So, yeah, I began recording, and, you know, as I was recording, I just noticed that, you know, there's a lot of WoW going on here because I'm talking about Blizzard. I'm comparing the two, and I realized that, you know, why not, you know, piece them together? And here we are, man. Well, I can't say enjoy, but what can I say? Well, I enjoyed it. That's the good part. So I think that's it for now, man. I actually flipped out entirely in the end. Began talking about this. I always get back to that on Clash for Gold and Rastinatan, Midnight Caller. But I actually cut that out because, you know, when editing, I had a lot of tracks, a lot of music, and I loved doing the soundtrack. And then when I got to that part, I just felt this, like, what kind of music can I have to this? And I just realized I had to cut it out. So just hope you don't have to listen to that ever. But if I come up with something, like an idea or something, I'll use it in a future something, who knows. But yeah. So WoW Gold meets Clash for Gold, and this is usually how I introduce my WoW Gold podcasts. Well, I always walk and talk when I do those usually, so fuck it. Anyways, that's it. Grays, I'm out. Peace. At first, I can't have a list. I can't have a path to take. I can't decide exactly what I'll be talking about, in what order, anything like that. The only thing I can do is choose something and run from there. So this is episode 6, and Clash of Clans is dead. It's over. It's hell on earth. The modders have won again. After 2 years of wars and Supercell not doing dick about it, they put on their big boy pants. They, you know, it was time to fight for the fair play community, and they did. I don't even use that phrase, but anyways, so they did. This was April. And they began banning people, you know. They went out there and on the forums and like, yeah, it's time, you know, it's us, we're here. They arrived. So, you know what, I'll actually just fucking simplify things. So the Fairplay Nazis, they go ham. They go really happy about this, and I can understand it, man. I was happy as well, you know. You know, it was Christmas, it was heaven, you know. It was raining angels, man, from the sky. You know, we were happy, and that lasted for a month, maybe a month and a half. Well, it actually didn't, because, you know, people were skeptic before that, and will it happen? Will they change? Will they ban people? Whatever, whatever. As usual, you know, got to complain. So that was then, you know, Clash of Clans died again. The Town Hall 11 update killed Clash of Clans. It had died then. Clash Con killed Clash of Clans. It died. The lack of updates during, let's see, 2015 killed Clash of Clans. So, I mean, there's not many players left here, you know, but it gets better. So 2016, 17th of May, and,
It's been a great day. I'm really enjoying myself here. It's I've been looking at The Flash season one, and I haven't really enjoyed it at all. Like, at all. And there's a scene there where Dr. Wells goes, "You're not a hero," like in the beginning. I think it's like the first episode or something. And that's how I feel about these Fairplay Nazis that go insane when it comes to... And that's the thing, man. I just have to say it that way because it's like, you know, the way people... It doesn't really matter what you call them. You know, it's... If you're a fundamentalist, you're a fundamentalist. And I understand, you know, you can't say certain words because it triggers people. And I understand that. But I get triggered as well, man. And I can trigger myself by making sure that I read stuff that triggers me. So when that happens, man, it's, you know, it's open war, man. It's hunting season, you know. Got Dan the Hero here on Twitter. Actually mixed him up with another guy from my clan. So I hopped in the conversation. UG Evolved was in that one as well. And we've warred in the North Faction a couple of months back. So I was like, yeah, you know, I recognize these names. So anyways, there was this tweet about, you know, shit going to hell, basically. I don't even remember the tweet because there's been so much, you know, Clash is so dead. People, so many people have quit today. It's just insane. It's like, if this happens, I'll quit. And I'll just quit now for reading this. You know, there's all kinds of reactions. And I've actually decided to... I'm actually calmer than I should be. Like, if this was WoW or Gold, I would just... Maybe I should... Fuck. I might need to do a recording where it's... I walk and talk and just insanity. Because I think that can bring out the raw edge. Like the real Grays. Because it's so... I'm having so much fun, man. It's insane. And I know that I'll have music in the background. And I just fucking love it. You know, every second. I'll have death metal. I'll have fucking choirs. I'll have, you know, all kinds of shit, man. This is like, yeah, The Doors, man. You know, there's so many songs, man. The soundtrack of Graze's life. So anyways... And I'm not, this is important, man. I'm not really calling, first things first. So when I say fair play Nazi, it's basically you're a fundamentalist. You could be whatever, man. It doesn't really matter. I'm not a part of the fair play community. I don't cheat. I will never do it. It's so fucking uninteresting. And when I get into this update now, which is basically... I don't even remember what it's called because it doesn't really matter. But basically, you can do attacks over and over on the same base. So let's say a friend of mine sets up a base and I'm like, yeah, I want to attack this base. He sets it up. I don't even know how that works. I think it's kind of like if I was Supercell, I'd set it up in a way so it's kind of like I pick a base and it's kind of like I screenshot it and then I add that to my pool of bases and then I add it to my base. Of course it can be like you build it manually, but it's kind of like, that's not 2016. I mean, come on, man. You create all these, quality of life improvements and then you got to have me build that base manually. It's kind of like, I don't know, but let's say that happens. So I actually have to build that base manually. So I do that, send it over to a friend of mine and he can attack it and see how that goes. And he can do it over and over, you know, he creates different troops, at no cost, really. But basically, he sets up like, okay, I'll do this. Well, actually, you set up your comp. You know what? Fuck the details. Because that would change anyways. I mean, it's patch notes. And that's the funny thing, man. Patch notes. People, like, they go insane after reading notes about changes that are to come. But that actually still could change. I understand that people have this vision of Supercell. Like, yeah, they do what they say. They don't change their minds, they don't listen, they don't, you know, feedback and whatever. But the way that I look at it is, the good thing with Blizzard 1.0 back in the day was they had their own idea of how they wanted to create their game. And then eventually some of the ideas that they like got from other people, like from outside of Blizzard, you know, got in there. And, you know, like, let's say transmog, that's not something that they were like, yeah, we'll use transmog in WoW. You know, they were like totally against that. But down the road, you know, they actually created like this whole transmog system. And that's something that hasn't been, you know, a part of one expansion. It has, you know, been a part of, like, ever since it was released in Kata, you know, they've had it in every single expansion. And that's been like one of the most important things they've ever done in that game. I'm not really into transmog. Transmog is basically, I have my gear and I can make it look like other gear, you know. But what I'm saying here is, that was Blizzard 1.0. So the way that I looked at Supercell is that they're very, from the outside looking in, I've seen like them doing a lot of Blizzard moves, especially up until, let's say, this year, actually. So up until Clash Con and the Town Hall 11 update and whatever, they just keep on putting out shit. They're trying to, I don't know what, they're like, yeah, something special is coming. Yeah, we're going to do this, we're going to do that. And people are like getting all hyped up for months. I was on my break then for a year, so I wasn't really into this, but, you know, I caught up. That's what I do. When I come back from a break, I make sure that I get a picture of like the change of the landscape, you know, what has changed, what has happened. So I listen a lot to podcasts and whatever. And that's actually when I found By Forever, that show, and just went through like fucking, I don't know, 40 episodes, because I actually picked out the ones I want to listen to. But is someone crying? Shit. Hold on. Right. So anyways, there wasn't anyone crying. I thought the one-year-old Stonewinds was crying in the background. So anyways, Supercell, they're getting into this mode where they're creating all of these promises. People, you know, they're so hyped up about Clash Con. Yeah, we're finally going to get arranged wars. We're going to get arranged wars. And I'm listening to this and I'm like, dudes, you don't get it, do you? It's like, whenever someone says, like, yeah, we're going to do this, we're going to do that, it's fucking magic, you know, it'll blow your pants off, whatever. What you do is you hear it, and then you go, right, I'll wait till it happens. You know, it doesn't matter what anyone thinks. It doesn't matter if a podcaster says something, if a YouTuber thinks something, or a sneak peeks or whatever. It doesn't matter, man. What matters is what gets on the server. That's the only thing that matters. So, like, if they release patch notes, they didn't do it back then. 2015, that much, their communication was garbage. Blizzard 1.0. But I mean, I'd say Blizzard 2.0 had worse communication, because, you know, it went, they like sidestepped each other in so many ways. But anyways, so Supercell, they get into this mode where, yeah, we're finally going to do something big for Clash Con, man. We're going to create this and blah, 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 and it's going to be huge. You know, we're going to have wars and we're going to do blah, blah. And people are so hyped up. And that turns to shit. It's like just total fucking fuckfest, man. And now this is me actually not even, I wasn't there. I wasn't, like, this is like after the fact, right? So, but what happens is, playing World of Warcraft for like 9 years, I've had breaks, man. I have long breaks. I mean, this break now has been like a year or something. So, I mean, maybe I played 7. Who cares? I've still been in it, you know, like mentally, like, okay, I'm going to do this next expansion. I'm going to prepare this way. I'm going to, you know, whatever. So it's not like I've left the game. I don't quit unless I quit. And while I was in a game that I'd be like, yeah, I quit, you know, fuck that. It's more like a fucking, I guess I'd quit if I really felt like I'm done, you know, but I'm not there yet, so we'll see. Anyways, so Blizzard change. They go from like, we don't tell anyone anything, we release the game when it's done, and we do top-notch shit, right? That's basically Clash of Clans when they have this secret sauce. So then Blizzard 2.0 is basically when they get Ghostcrawler on Twitter. He was an old, I don't even know what the fuck he was. Doesn't matter. He's gone. Long gone, man. Several years now. So they get Ghostcrawler on. I know this is a lot of WoW, but this ties into the whole, like, why I'm even talking about this Fairplay Nazi shit. Because what happens is you have gamers acting like bitches. And when that happens, you got to connect it to, like, what the fuck's going on here? You know, you got to set a fucking landscape or basically understand the landscape. It's like, you know, I'm going into enemy. Oh, my God. It's like I'm going into enemy territory. And for me to be ready, but not only that, for you to be ready for what I'm going to talk about, you need to get a picture of, like, what the fuck I'm thinking here. So what I'm thinking is basically Ghostcrawler runs, he's on Twitter, and he's one of these guys that he was great at communicating. You know, he had sarcasm, he had passion. He was a good guy. Oh, fuck, I should have been drinking water. So, you know what, I'll take a little break here, drink some water, and fuck that, I'll just add some music to this. Enjoy. Oh my God, yeah, this microphone. Yay! So anyways, Ghostcrawler had great communication. He was one guy, and he was like fucking insane. He was insane. I was following him, but I wasn't reading all these tweets. I wasn't really like, because I don't get into that whole fanboy thing. Like, I become a complete fanboy I was a fanboy of Blizzard. Might be hard to believe with WoW and Gold, but I really believed in Blizzard once in a time. Like, really, like, yeah, I have to buy every single game they have and whatever. But this was before Hearthstone, and this was before Heroes of the Storm. Those two games, especially Hearthstone, was when I began understanding that, okay, this is Blizzard 2.0, and it's time to have a different outlook on that company. So Ghostcrawler, he was great. He brought the pain, you know, if there were trolls, if there were idiots, you know, saying things, he would just, you know, bring the hammer down on them and just say it as it was, you know. So he quits, and they try to replace the guy with someone called Celestalon. And, like, kind of instantly, you know, I'm like, what the fuck's going on with this dude? Because it's like he is not Ghostcrawler. And I can understand that, man. You don't replace a guy. Basically, people are people, right? So, I mean, if I'm Graze, I don't go like, hey, I'm going to call myself Pennyworth. And I'm going to act like as if I'm a doctor who something, something, you know? Oh, yeah, Peabody, Gotham. Guess that, yeah, that's the why. Anyway, so what happens is that goes to shit. Celestalon's out of the loop. They get rid of him when it comes to Twitter. I mean, he's still on there, but he doesn't do that Ghostcrawler shit. And then they try to have, like, several developers talk shit. Like, okay, yeah, this is happening, and it's all good. People are happy. It's like, yeah, Blizzard are communicating. They're giving us all this information. And then what happens is the information doesn't match up. It doesn't add up. You know, things happen in the game, and it's like, what the fuck? You shouldn't have said this. You shouldn't have said that. And suddenly, it's like you can't trust anything Blizzard says. And then we have this expansion, which is out now, Warlords of Draenor, where they promised a lot of shit. There was a lot of jokes about things being savage. And most players really hate it. You know, they hated Cataclysm back in the days, and they hate Warlords. And what happened there is basically that, you know, if you go into, like, if you follow anyone, it doesn't matter if it's a game, a band, or whatever the fuck, and you don't, like, read the signs, like, if the signs are there, and you know how to, like, okay, this is happening, I better be cautious about this right now, you know, then you might do fine. But if you're, like, blindly, like, yeah, these guys have always been good, they'll always be great, and they're the same kind of company now that they were when they were, like, 200 less people or whatever, I don't care about the numbers, but you know what I mean. If you're that naive, you don't really understand what it is when something grows. It's basically like a human being, man. If I'm a child, if I'm 5 years old, and later on, I'm like 10 years later, I'm 15 years old, I have grown, you know. I've grown larger, things have happened, experiences, whatever the fuck. Same happens with companies, right? So Blizzard didn't have people quit just because they felt like, yeah, you know, I'm going to quit this job because I love it. Fuck no, man. You know, things change. You know, there's change of leadership. There's a new guard. And that's why Blizzard 2.0 is so much less interesting to me compared to 1.0. Now, this wasn't something that I was planning on talking about at all, but I'll get to Supercell soon enough. Oh my God, this will be a while. So I guess I have hours to record. So anyways, when Warlords comes out, well, basically, it doesn't really matter which expansion I'm talking, well, fuck it, you know, I'm me. So when I listen to this, I want to understand what the fuck I'm talking about. So let's say Cataclysm comes out, Mists of Pandaria comes out. Mists of Pandaria, basically between Mists of Pandaria and Cata, there's a lot of communication. Ghostcrawler quits before Mists comes out. That's the way I remember it. Doesn't really matter anyways. So he quits. Celestalon happens during Mists of Pandaria. Blizzard, for some reason, have this bullshit thing about, yeah, we're going to release more content faster. And this is not the players saying we want more content faster. We just want good content. That's it. If you have good content, I mean, if you look at fucking BC, I had content that I was playing for years. I know it wasn't years, but that's the way I'll say it, because it was new to me. So it was like a larger experience. And that's why it's so fun to be a newbie in anything, man. It's like the experiences when you're new to something, you know, it's always like so much larger. That's why I love, you know, learning new things. So anyways, back in Burning Crusade, they had content that you didn't have to do, but there was a lot of different content. You could do attunements for raids, you could do PvP, you could do dungeons, you could, you know, farm different sets. There were all kinds of things you could do, get mounts, whatever, trying to get gold cap, actually just making gold was fucking hell back then. But the thing was that they didn't tell you what to do. It wasn't like a fucking theme park where it's like, you have to do this in this order. You know, you can level in zones. Of course, there were like levels, like you have to be level 68 to 70, like in fucking Netherstorm or whatever. Maybe even 70, 69 to 70, I don't know. But but that was back then when it was Blizzard 1.0, right? It was like, you can decide what you want to do. I mean, we've set up the rules for the game and then you play the game. And then 2.0 was like this whole theme park thing where it's like, okay, we create a game and we want you to go exactly like fucking on rails. When you quest, you go in this order. When you do the zones, you have to do them in this order. And you can't do them any other way. You know, all kinds of bullshit just popped up. Now, so in Warlords, people were like, yeah, this is going to be a great expansion. They're bringing back the orcs. They're going to do the fucking, I mean, people were tired about orcs. And that's another thing, man. People, players will always complain. Always. Doesn't matter what happens. They will always complain. So let's say I want an expansion that's all, you know, bringing it back to Burning Crusade. And then it's like, oh, fucking Legion is taking it back to Burning Crusade. Why? You know? But that also depends on the outlook. Like, what's your perspective on it? So, I mean, for me, them going back to Legion and Burning Crusade and whatever is like, you can't go back. That's the first thing. Don't ever go back. What you need to do is just go fucking forward, man. Take what's good, move forward. The lore has gone to shit because you retconned that shit and you created a fucking, what's that called? Created a fucking, can't find the word. They created this whole time travel thing and that just messed things up even more. And that's another thing with the whole like Blizzard 1.0 and 2.0 thing where Blizzard in the past, they had their lore, they had their ideas, and they wouldn't piggyback on who is the big bad guy. Warlords of Draenor, I knew that I had less time to play. Family life, 3 kids, you know, Stormwinds was going to be born. She was born like basically, I think she was born weeks before Warlords came out. Yeah, something like that. So, I mean, I was really like, I had a hard time playing the game. I think I played Warlords for like 3 months. Maybe 4. And I kind of knew this from the get-go that I would be tight. Like, I'd have to be, you know, keep the time sink slow and just fucking... wow, is this actually like... This might actually be WoW for gold. Fuck it, I'll actually create like a fucking multi-episode where it's like a fucking WoW or Gold beats Clash for Gold shit, because it's like Supercell versus Blizzard. Fucking Superman shit. Anyways, so, yeah, Warlords, I have my, and this is also like the whole family life has made me more hardcore. Like for every single kid I get more hardcore. I get more like, okay, I want to learn this. I want to do that. I want to become more competitive, but I have less time. So how can I do it? And this is something Thooorin talks about as well, which is the whole idea of like, if you have someone playing a game and you're like, yeah, that guy is successful, or that guy is good at what he does or whatever, like what an achievement or whatever. It's not just about like, okay, that guy won this because of that or whatever. Like, yeah, he was good. It's also a lot about like the circumstances. So if I become good at something now, when I have three kids, less time, it's a lot more of an accomplishment than if I had a lot more time like in the past before I had the kids, but was a lot less efficient, you know? So this whole hardcore deal has made me a lot more efficient when it comes to like, okay, what's my goal? How can I get there? And how the fuck can I do it without fucking neglecting my family? Oh, so many topics, man. It's been so long, huh? So Blizzard turned to shit when it comes to communication. And they try this whole open, like, we're going to be open about all this thing. And then it backfires because, you know, the player base gets... Well, it's not even the player base, but basically the people that use social media and the forums, they become like, especially Twitter, man, because, you know, I can be a dev, I can sit on my couch, I'm a bit drunk, I've been drinking some wine, you know, my girlfriend's in the shower, and, you know, I get a tweet, and I'm like, yeah, I answer this, I'm so cool, I'm so fly, and then I sober up. And I noticed that, oh shit, that's not what I meant. I meant, you know, and, you know, shit's hit the fan, you know, Twitter fell apart. So they went silent again. You know, they tried to go Blizzard 1.0. But the problem was that they did in a sense where they didn't communicate that, yeah, we're going to be more silent. And, you know, players began becoming a lot more like, oh fuck, what the fuck's going on here? So they began doing these brash decisions. And people thought that they were Blizzard 1.0, but they weren't. It was 2.0. And the biggest difference is heart. If I just say Blizzard, back in the days, it was all about heart. It was all about the games, basically. They were a smaller company. They had less franchises. It was a lot... I would say that the leadership, now this is from the outside looking in, but I mean, I've been working in different kinds of fields where I can see the difference in leadership depending on like basically the size of something as well. So like the size of an organization, plus I've studied this as well. So the size of an organization can decide how they communicate. So when it's a smaller company, it's easier to be transparent and have everyone on board, but you can basically be a lot more like, it's easier to have relationships that last in a sense, compared to if you're like in a larger company where you're just a one big part of a big hub. And that's basically why I'd say that people are quitting, like Zarheim and fucking Crypto. I don't even care about Crypto, but you know, there's like these names, Bashiok, Ghostcrawler, Rob Pardo, you know, there's, the list is long, man, and it's just going to keep on going. And hopefully Devilore doesn't quit, but, you know, down the line, he probably might. But so what happens is that when you have this shady, and that's another thing, man. Back then, Blizzard didn't waste time like, okay, we decided on this. It's wrong, we'll just still go for it, you know? Or basically, they wouldn't say that they were wrong, they would just fucking go for it and be like, okay, yeah, we'll listen to your feedback, but, you know, we don't know, we'll see. But then they got to this era where they wanted the player base to decide a lot more, and there was so much piggybacking, and that just hurt the business. And this is basically Supercell around Clash Con. especially after ClashCon. Well, now around ClashCon, because what Supercell did before was they would do their own thing, and then people want things, but they would like listen, but in their own way, they would like reinvent ideas and whatever. What would happen would be that, shit, I need a break. Fuck. Yeah, I need a break. Fuck this. I'll get back to you guys. Oh, shit. Yeah, so the idea would be that Supercell wouldn't listen to the audience that were playing the game. Well, basically the player base. And they would do their own shit. And just like Blizzard back in the past. And then they got to this period where they released Town Hall 11, and they just did these weird decisions. I don't even remember what the fuck they did, but it just, to me, it felt like they just turned into fucking Blizzard. They basically released Clash Royale as well. So for me, that was Blizzard releasing Hearthstone. Actually, I can do it like this, so you get a picture of like how I look at it, like why I connect Supercell to Blizzard. So Supercell at first, they don't listen. Blizzard didn't listen. And then, you know, everything goes as planned. Well, actually, things go better than planned, and they're like the most popular game, whatever. This is both Supercell and Blizzard when it comes to, like, let's say WoW and CoC. Because those are the two games that I connect, although, because they have been the biggest cash cows for both companies. Now, I think that changed with time, especially for Blizzard. So they had their cash cows, they had their ups, and then they had their downs, where they're like, okay, shit's going downhill. Let's try and slow down the deterioration here. Players are leaving. How can we stop it? They get desperate. They do all these kind of bullshit moves. They get acquired by companies that have a different mindset. For good or bad, I don't know. But, you know, this is just things that I connect to both. Like, Blizzard, they have Activision. And then Supercell, they have this, I think it's a Japanese company. Might be Chinese, I'm not sure. Haven't done the research on that because it doesn't really matter. And that's not because I have anything against Asians or anything. It's more like just, it's more like in a sense, Blizzard burned me out. So I haven't really put my effort into looking into any other gaming company. I'm not really interested in that in the same way that I was in the past. I just catch this as I go from the outside looking in. But and then they released Clash Royale. Both are card games. Both are very easy to manage. Both require very little time to upkeep when it comes to like creating cards or whatever the fuck. They have systems that are a lot like you can play the games, like let's say Clash of Clans and World of Warcraft, they have a long timeline. You know, had to play them over a long fucking period of time. You had to put in hours, you know, all that shit, you know, upgrades, whatever, the farm, you know, they're grinding games. And oh my God, I just killed the mic. Oh, you know, they're grinding games. Fuck my lungs. Ooh. Shit, dude. Oh, should have bought a Porsche, dude. Oh, with my baby horse, dude. Clash of Clans, Clash of... Oh, anyways. So, my God. Fuck me, dude. Oh, that hurt. So, I think I killed somebody there. So, oh, shit, I forgot where I was. Fuck it. I'll get back. Yeah, basically, the idea for those both companies, Blizzard and Supercell, is that, you know, we create these games so that we can keep players playing our games now that our cash cows are falling down. We can't keep them in WoW. We can't keep them in Clash of Clans all the time. So what can we do? Hearthstone. Yeah, let's do that. You know, simplified magic. I didn't play that game. Magic the Gathering game, I guess you could say. Like a simplified card game. Because that's what Blizzard do. They take other people's ideas and then they simplify it, merge it together and make it like a casual, friendly, whatever the fuck. Simple to get into, hard to master, kind of fucking old school slogan that isn't active anymore. That's like fucking years ago because they're dumbing everything down, simplifying things. Fucking pisses me off. Sorry, that was... Well, I guess this is WoW or Gold, doesn't matter. You know, it's both podcasts in one, Clash for WoW or Gold. So, that's the good thing with being flexible, man. You survive these dark fucking days when everything dies. Like, WoW dies, cock dies. Fuck it. So, then there is... Supercell, they try to create their... Because this is the difference. Warcraft has a lore. Like, there's a big story behind that whole shit. There's a whole universe. Supercell are going for the simpler version. Basically, this is something that people have spoken about in the past. They should have toys or merchandise or whatever the fuck with Clash of Clans on, which is true. I mean, it's like a missed opportunity. But they do things their way. So, anyways, when they release Clash Royale, it's basically like the whole Hearthstone model. It's a simple thing to do, whatever the fuck. It's a lot less, I guess. No, it is. There's a lot less balancing and problem issues that you can have with that game than you can have. I mean, of course there can be. I mean, who the fuck knows, man? It's like Russian roulette, dude. But the thing is, it's a lot less demanding on the team. You can have a smaller team on Clash Royale than you can if on Clash of Clans. And I mean, they say that they work in small cells, in like Supercell. We should probably do, but I mean, it's like different. It's different kind of games. You can't compare them. Fuck them. So, anyways, what happens is the Clash of Clans community, a part of it feels like you're neglecting us, man. You're leaving us to dry out here. Well, to die. Sorry, and I'm a part of it, man. I'm a part of that, man. I'm a, like when they began with the fucking Hearthstone shit, and especially when they began, because this is another thing with Blizzard, old school Blizzard. They invite you to an alpha. They invite you to a beta. They drop the game when it's done. They're done. Blizzard now, it's like, we're having an open beta. 1 million people in our beta. Miss Pandaria went to shit. You know? We had too many people in our beta. And then Warlords of Draenor. Too many people in our... You know, it's like, fucking Christ, man. And then there's this whole data mining thing where, like, nothing is sacred anymore. Like back in the days, like let's say fucking Wrath days, you know, all the information wasn't out there. You didn't know everything that would happen in the expansion, you know. Things were actually like, oh, I don't know what will happen here. Nice. Now you know everything, you know, everything's available. So there's a lot less draw just from that for me. You know, I want things fresh, you know. But I mean, you gotta adapt or you just quit. So for me now, it's like in Warcraft, it's, I don't need to play the expansion all the way through. It's a different company. They don't care. I don't care. So I'll play it the way that I want to play it, especially the way that they're doing things now. I will avoid the time sinks as much as possible. I will read the guys that I have to, and I'll level as fast as possible, and I'll just fucking be as competitive that I can within the time frame that I have. So basically, my challenge is to be entertained. Are you not entertained? By playing as hardcore as I can, but by being as much as a father as I can at the same time. And that's like a balance that I'm loving right now. It's like, I don't have it mastered, probably never will, but it's like a good, it's a great challenge to have. You know, I feel blessed when it comes to that part, man. I feel like I've been given a second chance, for real. And that's just fucking great. Yeah, because when little Graves, when he was like 1 year old, I didn't give a fuck, man. I was just like too caught up in, like I couldn't take care of my own problems. So I just fucking neglected my family and stuff and just fucking went AWOL. Now, you know, I'm trying to find like support groups and shit, talk about stuff, you know, have help, communicate, all that good stuff, man. Anyways, so these fucking companies, they create these perfect games. And I just simplify things now, so I need to fucking go to sleep, sadly. But so they create these perfect games, and things change. They want to make that money, keep making that money. They get desperate. They come up with other ideas, and they start focusing more on the new games, the different endeavors, instead of, like, their old cash grab. Understandable. It's oh my God. Understandable. It's a business. No problem there. But some players feel betrayed. Now, the big difference here for me between these two companies is actually, and I haven't even gotten into like the topic, which is why I'm recording this. Like the whole, you can attack your own friends' bases and all that shit. The reactions from the fucking Twitter community, the Fairplay Nazis, the dying people of the world, you know, the people in need, the people that don't have the food, the Wi-Fi, the will to play the game, you know, the outcries from those people is what made me go, fuck it, I'm recording as soon as possible. And, I mean, that's what drives me, man. It's like, I feed on your tears. I'm Graze, man. I'm a cow. I'm a fucking Thooorin from Thunderbluff. So, yeah, I think I'll have to leave it there for now. But it's one of these things where I'm just happy to be alive, man. Playing Clash now, seeing this many deaths in such a short time, hilarious, man, hilarious. And like, you know, I'm born and raised in Sweden, and I have a Zimbabwean heritage, right? So like with my family, father and mother. So with, when it comes to like, what the hell is that called, man? When it comes to like Sweden, there's like this whole melancholy. There's like this whole depressed thing where everyone just is fucking down in Sweden. It's like you can't be too happy. There's this thing called Jantelagen where, can't even explain it, but it's kind of like, don't think that you're better than anyone else. Don't think that you're cooler than anyone else. It's like this fucking whole co-dependency system that just breaks you down, but no one speaks about it. So it's like a fucking system that's sick, that's just there, right? And this affects people on a level that live here in a way that you can't really combat, because it's like a part of everything. Because even when it's like it has disappeared, it hasn't. It's like fucking weird. But it just feels like fucking the whole, not even the whole, but parts of this whole clashing community, whatever the fuck, is just so fucking emo. It's so pure fucking emo, man. It's like, you know, slit your wrists, drop the game, get out, you know. You're an addict, accept that you're an addict, get the fuck out, get help, do whatever you fucking need to do, man. Gamers Anonymous, I don't know, Alcoholics Anonymous, you know, you might have other issues, get into that, get it fixed. That's what I did, man. Codependency isn't, it's not a fucking game, man. So it's fun to record, man. I'm enjoying this, and I've really felt like I don't want to record solo. It's really been like, oh, man, I don't really want to record solo. Because it's all learning curves, man. You know, I have things I want to do, I have things I want to learn. And I've got some ideas on how I'm going to branch out. But I mean, episodes like this, I'll just go solo. And then, you know, I mean, topics like this, man. It's so funny, man. It's so funny. Anyways, I have to pull the fucking plug out of myself here. Pull the plug on my ass. So, Blizzard, Supercell, there's a lot of connections. I'll actually get back to this topic because it's so fucking huge. But The way that I look at it now is Supercell has changed their strategy and they have surpassed Blizzard. People can say that, but yeah, but they don't have the same amount of success. They don't have the same amount of like whatever the whatever. But the difference is, and this is also like Thooorin, man. Thooorin is fucking God. If you want to be competitive, if you want to compare his Alpha Draft commercials, man. I might even try and do one of those, man. Let's see if I come up with something. So if you're bored and you want to be competitive, you might have to sign up for Alpha Draft. You know, get a chance to win that 6 Scrilla. Fuck it, I can't do Thooorin. Anyways, I should sleep. I should farm as well, man. I'll get into that later. It's just weird, man. I'm a fucking Masters. It's weird. Oh, so many weird things going on right now. Troop updates and shit. Anyway, so where the fuck was I? Yeah. So Supercell. You know what? Fair play, Nazis. Since we're in Germany, you know, this is old school 1944 Europe shit. I just feel like you lost the war. Shit went downhill. You thought you had the martyrs, you know, they were gone. You know, you were like, yeah, the modding is dead. It's dead forever. It's never coming back. Gru TV did this interview with a guy, D3, about hacking. Interesting thing, man. So yeah, modding's not gone, but I mean, if you can hack the servers, you can do other things, right? That might be worse than modding, but anyways, so now that we have countries dying, Stormwind's waking up, it's time to say goodbye. I'll get back to you guys, and this has been one fucking weird ride, but I'm so happy that I'm in Clash right now. And, yeah, I'll leave it there. Like a voice in the night. I need to see what the fuck that is. You know what? I'm actually going to do it on the fly. I know that usually when people like, yeah, I'm going to search for this. And it gets like all like silent and weird and whatever the fuck. Actually doesn't get weird, just gets silent. But what I'll do is actually like this. And rest in nothing. Look at this. I've written E-N space. R, right? So this is in Swedish. The choices are Andreasa Fedida and Rakash. And then number 4. Andres. I wasn't born in the fucking 90s, I was born in the 70s. Anyway, fuck that shit. So let's see.